this was the next generation of model that we made. You see, this is the model, this is the AVM, and you can hold the model in the hand, you can take the model in the operation theater, and you can see the vessels going in the AVM. These operations are almost impossible neurosurgical operations. So you can see this model being held in the hand and taken. This, of course, is a good model, and it gives a lot of additional information, but the models then subsequently improved. You will be surprised that we from India were the first one in the world to introduce 3D models in the study of arteriovenous malformations of the brain. And it is, you know, usually we talk of technologies, we, you know, that technology is from the West and we are techniques. This is the, you know, normal kind of talk going on. But here we introduce first 3D models of AV malformation in the world. So this is the arteriovenous malformation, and this is the, you know, our subsequent model of 3D model. And you can imagine, you can exactly delineate from where the vessels are going and where the, this model and where the vessel is draining on which surface. You can operate on this also, but this gives you much more information. You can hold the model in the hand and you can mark the surgical flap. These are very critical issues in neurosurgery, where exact point of the head is important, and then you remove the AV malformation. This is another AVM. You see how the model is showing the vessels, and it is the surface vessels on the skull are seen so beautifully. This lady comes with an AVM. You see, this is the large arteriovenous malformation with severe headache. These kind of lesions are impossible to treat in the world of neurosurgery. So we treated this with intraoperative image, with intraoperative angiography, and you see, this is the model, 3D model. And these models we are making on a regular basis, and you can give actually this beautiful smile on the patient's face, and the AVM is completely resected, and this girl is entirely cured. I have no hesitation to say that this model has been of great help. This is another AVM which is in a critical area of the brain, and this is the model that we made. According to the model, there are various kinds of information that we could get, and we remove this AVM. So this AVM surgery has evolved in the era of CT scan and MRI and angiography, digital subtraction angiography, but these models have really revolutionized. So this is the AVM. Now you see here, we made a model. So this is the model, and then we can mark the location on the head, and then we can design the surgery, and you can give a beautiful, you can resect this. These are difficult operations, and we, on the basis of this model, we designed an alternative approach from the contralateral side. So this is the AVM on this side. We approached the AVM from the contralateral side. So this was a quite a beautiful operative strategy. So this is the AVM. This is CT angiogram. This is CT angiogram. This is digital subtraction angiography. And now you see the beauty of this 3D model. So this 3D model is our next stage. You can see exactly where the vessels are coming. You can hold the model in your hand. You can take it in the operation theater. You can continuously, you know, this is life size, as good as the patient size. And you can hold the model in your hand and then ultimately resect this AVM and give new life to the person. This is another AVM. Is a good angiography, can be good, but model gives you much better information. So this is the 3D model that we made, and we made a beautiful surgical resection on this difficult case. And this is the arteriovenous malformation, which is quite an impossible surgical, and this is post-operative result. So this is the model, and this is the AVM, and you can imagine it gives wonderful new information which was not available on regular investigation. This is another model. And now I will give you the 3D, how it helps in reconstruction. So this is the skull, and we have how to reconstruct following injury. If there is an injury to the head, you can use MRI, you can use CT scan, but exact, this is the 3D model, and you see how beautifully it shows the holes in the skull from where there is a CSF leakage. So this is a patient with CSF leakage. You can find the CSF from the brain is coming into the nose, and this is a dangerous and life-threatening situation. At this time, we need all kinds of investigations. We did these kind of 3D models, and this is another patient. Information can be acquired from the CT scan, but these 3D models give you exact delineation of the fracture line, holes in the base of the skull, and you can treat accordingly. So there is no question to have this kind of information in the operation theater is absolutely critical. Other thing that where we use model on a regular basis, and we describe for the first time in the literature in 2016, use of 3D models in craniovertebral junction surgery, where our work is amongst the best in the world, without any doubt. So these 3D models can be made with special technology, which the radiologist and Shibu John will be expert in this. So this is the case, and we have to do this kind of instrumentation. This is extremely, we describe this technique, and we have created a revolution in the field of this craniovertebral junction. But to get information as to, you see this artery, vertebral artery, to identify the location of vertebral artery, and then to do instrumentation is absolutely critical in these cases. So this 3D model gives you that kind of information as to where to put the screw and where to do this C1 screw and how to avoid this vertebral artery. These are very, very critical information required in the surgery, and these 3D models, they believe me, I am doing this kind of surgery for the last 30 years. And this kind of C1, C2 screw fixation is not easy, but the information that you can get from 3D models is absolutely fantastic. And this 3D model information can result in giving a new life to this patient. You can imagine this beautiful 3D model. This is the artery, and we have to protect the artery. It gives exact information about the location of artery, and then you can do your surgery. You can see this another 3D model that we have made, and I'm not sure how many of the audience is neurosurgeons, but those who can in neurosurgery will realize the absolute criticality of this understanding, which no other investigation can give. So these are the 3D models which we take in the operation theater, and these three models, 3D models are used now on a regular basis. You see this patient having a very critical anomaly in the craniovertebral junction. It is impossible to treat this patient unless you have a very good anatomical delineation. So this is the 3D model that we made on this, and we gave this person an absolute wonderful smile. Smile is a part, but we gave him hands and we gave him legs and a new life and a new vision for his life. So the advantage of 3D models is that you can hold the model in your hand and work in various positions during surgery. Surgery can be rehearsed. The model is actual patient size. It shows accurately the location and orientation of the facets. It